bad dude.
I got my first real job when I was 17 years old in a toy store. They hired me to clean up and reshelve toys, but all I really did was teach myself how to juggle, and they fired me. But hey, I did learn how to juggle. My second job, I was a busboy. The restaurant had a big walk-in refrigerator, and they found me in that refrigerator smoking pot out of a carrot, and they fired me. But hey, I did learn how to make cool pipes. Of course, I stopped smoking weed years ago, but I do have a handy bag of my pubic hair. Yeah, dude. My third job was as a dishwasher, and I just wasn't good at it, man. I wasn't cut out for it. You can ask Lux, I'm still not cut out for it.
Steve washes the dishes probably once a month, if that. And when he does, he's so proud. He documents it and then sends it to me just for like an attaboy.
So my fourth job was as a pizza delivery driver. And I got fired after my very first delivery because it took me 45 minutes to go literally around the corner. The thing is, I suck at driving. Right here, I got in an actual accident. They had a police report. Up here, I just forgot that I was so tall. Even with the rear camera, I'm just not that good at backing up. Obviously, I shouldn't have been driving in the first place, so whatever. But let's get out of here, dude. I'll drive. And then after my pizza fail, I got another busboy job where I made like 50 bucks a night. And that ruled because I was homeless. But when I ended up in the hospital with the surgery on my leg, they were kind of bummed because I couldn't work. And then as soon as I could walk again, I landed on my fucking face and broke my skull. And they were like, dude, we're done with you. You're fired. And after that, I didn't even try to have a job until after clown college. I got a job in a nightclub getting paid to dress up as a clown and light myself on fire. And I got fired from that for being too drunk all the time. And then I got a job as a clown on cruise ships, and I got fired from that because all of the clowns I worked with said, Steve-O is a dick, and if he gets another contract, we all quit. And yeah, I was a dick. And thank God, because if they hadn't gotten me fired, then I would have missed out on being on the Jackass pilot. Because as soon as I was jobless, I reached out to Jeff Tremaine at Big Brother Magazine. And I was like, yo, I've got all these crazy ideas. And he was like, cool. And then when we shot them, he was like, oh yeah, we're doing this for MTV. But yeah, pilots don't just turn into TV shows overnight. So I had to wait for like 6 months. And in that time, I was working as a clown in the circus at the flea market. But I got fired from that one too. Fuck. And because I got fired from that circus job, when Jackass came out, I was broke, unemployed, homeless. It was bad. But it all worked out, man, because Jackass was a success. And holy crap, look at this. Brand new Steve-O shirts. Still dumb, still tough. In black too? Oh my God. Available at steveo.com right now. But now we're gonna get into the crazy jobs I got fired from. Because in 2007, I got my own show called Dr. Steve-O.
And I've waged a war against wussiness in America.
The show had its moments.
You are officially a raging badass.
My personal challenge is to have Steve-O whip my ass with a wet towel.
Got the highest ratings in its entire time slot, but because I wrote emails to like 200 people attacking the network executives, I was fired. And for the beginning of every episode of Dr. Steve-O, I recorded this awful rap song because I was a rapper at the time.
I'm Steve-O and I'm hitting the road, so I'm making a bitchin' TV show. It's all about making the world a better place, kidnapping wussies and setting them straight.
Believe it or not, I actually got a record deal with Universal Music Group to record a comedy gangster rap album. And I made a bunch of songs with like real rappers like Be Real, M.O.P., Kool G Rap. But before the album came out, they fired me. They shelved the album, they threw it away because it was garbage and because I was an out of control mess on drugs.
Like, come on, dude, leave it to the lawyers, dude. Let's be rock stars.
let's be rap gangsters.
And I went to rehab and just tried to put my rap career behind me. And then I got into comedy, which has actually worked out super well for me.
Thank you, Austin. Fuck yeah.
But back in 2011, I got a job as the host of this show on True TV called Killer Karaoke. And the idea was that people would sing songs while terrible things happened to them.
Right now, he's probably
And that show got pretty crazy, man. They dunked people in water tanks with snakes and alligators. They were shocking people. But a lot of the challenges on that show involved animals and weren't very nice to the animals. Like the snakes in the water, it was ice water and the snakes were cold-blooded. So the whole animal rights community got very upset, and I'm part of the animal rights community and I was upset. I'm like, how did I do that? So I told the network and the production company, I'm not gonna do challenges that have any animals. I'm just not gonna be a part of it. And so they fucking fired me, dude. They replaced me with Mark McGrath from Sugar Ray. And what a fun video, right? I got fired from a bunch of jobs. And I think that was exactly 10 too. But I'm telling you, man, still dumb, still tough. Grab these motherfuckers at stevo.com, dude. Like fucking pronto.